everyone. As you may have noticed, we are entering the post-genomic era, and scientists are increasingly more interested in linking physiological functions to genes and proteins. As a result, scientists are in desperate need of a technology that can help them reveal these physiological functions. Today, I'll introduce to you a technology that does just that. It is called Non-invasive Micro-test Technology, also known as NMT. NMT is an integrated system designed to detect specific and/or selective ionic and molecular activities in extracellular space. The following ions and molecules are currently available to scientists. But what is this technology about? In Massachusetts in the early 1990s, Dr. Lionel Jaffe, along with his associates, introduced the concept of the vibrating probe. Around the same time, a similar concept was proposed by Dr. Ian Newman in Australia. These concepts were the basis to the development of NMT, but this technology evolves every day to fit the ever-changing needs of its users. Unlike technologies that provide scientists with overall voltage, impedance, or current information, NMT tells you which ions and/or molecules you are measuring. This provides you with the most direct and crucial evidence to the physiological functions. NMT provides data on the fluxes of ions and molecules. This data shows information on both direction and magnitude. Additionally, NMT is able to measure signals as low as femtomoles, which makes it ideal for single-cell research. You may find yourself wondering if NMT is 100% non-invasive. The answer is both yes and no. It will really depend on your sample. For example, when you work with a small Arabidopsis seedling or the tail of a rat, NMT is completely non-invasive. But if you want to measure the epithelial cells of a leaf or the brain tissues of a rat, you will first have to dissect the tissues or cells from your sample. But once it's in the liquid media, your samples will not be touched again. Due to the nature of NMT, it is capable of working with single cells, a layer of cells, tissues, organs, and even small organisms, as long as they are in a liquid media. Here's an example of how NMT has been applied into real-life research. This is an Arabidopsis root that was tested using YoungerUSA's commercialized IAA sensor. With NMT, we were able to measure the IAA fluxes surrounding this root. Results indicated a huge efflux of IAA at the tip of the root. But as you move to other regions of the root, we see a minor influx of IAA. With this information, scientists are able to study the regulation of the growth of plants, which they were not able to study previously. This makes NMT a very powerful tool for scientists. Since the concept of NMT was introduced in the early 1990s, it has opened up a whole new dimension in science. NMT is one of just a few technologies able to study physiological functions of live samples in real time. Because of this, applications of NMT into biomedical research have been growing exponentially in recent years. We will cover these applications in a later video. For more information, please subscribe now or visit our website. Thank you for watching. See you later.